It's always great when you can go green. I love my
real, where would you go and why?
Ooh.
as well. We just like check it out and like skip down the other brick road and see the Wicked Witch. Oh, I know her. Why did I know her? Japan was. I was thinking to her.
Hello. Hi. You guys started one of my favorite TV shows, Friends, a few years ago. I was wondering what your favorite part of working with like the cast and everyone was.
Oh my god. Has anyone seen Fringe? I was a massive fan of that show, so when they asked me to be in it, I literally fell over dead, dying on all the fields. I couldn't believe it. I was like, oh god! I was such a big fan. And the first time I walked onto set, I walked into Walter's lab, and Walter was standing there in his coat, and they were all standing there because they'd just done a scene prior. It's like I climbed into the TV show. And then I did a scene where I was like pretending to faint, and I actually sort of got a little bit faint in real life. So John Noble, who plays Walter, said, can I get you anything? I'm like, no, don't worry about me. But he went off to craft service, and he came back with a bowl of candy for me. I'm like, so Walter handed me a bowl of candy. I'm like, oh my god, I fainted!
Thank you.
Hello. Nice t-shirt. Thank you.
So my question is, out of all the outfits
Lena
has worn, what is your favorite?
I was like, well, you mean when I'm white? Well, when I'm green, I like my hero Wicked Witch shebang. Oh, and then when I'm Zelina, I always liked, my favorite Zelina stuff for season 3, you know, wearing like tight leather skirts, the bow, and a sassy little hat. It was very like, I like that. Tight little petticoat and a cape, or as we called it in the costume department, a capage. Let's have a capage moment. Like, so silly. A cape and a leather petticoat. It's pretty hot.
Thank you. Love you.
Love you too. Hello?
Hi there.
Hi.
I was just going to ask you if you could be like the actual Zelina Wicked Witch for one day and had all your powers and everything, what would you do with that one day?
I would get on my broomstick and I would load it with bombs. And I would go around and I would eradicate any terrorists in the whole world and free the world of anybody that's going to do that to anybody else. And in doing so, not hurt anyone innocent because my bombs were that special. I love shows that give me hashtag all the feels, so the shows that make me cry are kind of my jam. I love having a good cry. But that's why I love This Is Us.
Thank you, love you.
Love you too. Hello.
Hello, my name is Alexandra, and I was wondering, what was the hardest part about becoming your character, personality-wise, from us?
It was shockingly easy, which I can't say it's been a bad thing. Probably bad. It came really easily to me, and I don't know why. I don't know how much more therapy I need to pay for. But it's weird. It's something about this character that I really connected to. So even when I had to just like go to the dark side or lose it or scream or cry, I just became her. And it's weird. It really, I'm genuinely going to be completely honest. It's almost like it happened to me as opposed to going, oh my gosh, I should do this. I never really had to think about it. It was like Zelina just took over my body. It was magic.
Thank you. I love your dress.
Hi.
Do you like playing good or evil better, and why?
Not evil, dear.
Thank you.
I don't know, maybe go to the spa, have a spa day. scrub her, see if the ring comes off. She probably needs a heading, let's be honest.
Learn her forever. You know when you just meet
meet someone, I'm like, "Please, please." And then I'll give you like, it was weird. It was this immediate sort of kinship with her, and we're very, very similar in a lot of ways. And I just automatically felt like she was part of my family. Our relationship is very similar to my relationship with my sister. It's like completely open and honest, and there's so much love and understanding there that I feel like if either one of us were to stumble, the other one would catch each other. And female friendship like that don't come around very often, so when you find them, it's like soulmates for life, you know? So she stuck with me forever. I apologize for that.
Woo!
I stuck to your butt. Sorry, not sorry. Bye! Most embarrassing moment.
Yeah.
When my neighbors fell off, embarrassing moment. No one's really played that many practical jokes on me, which is shocking. I get annoyed when I forget a line because I'm really obsessed about being completely off book, so I get annoyed with myself. That is really being embarrassed. But I have this weird, this sort of knee-jerk reaction that whenever I forget a line, I just say awful ones. I always swear. And there was one time my sister came to Vancouver to visit me. I was shooting a scene with Mr. Gold and Lana in his shop. And it was my close up. I was really into saying something to Lana. And I'm like, yeah! And I hear my sister all the way back in Video Village go, any strength into someone that's going through something, that to me is the most important part of the show. For my experience on the show, that if I've ever done anything to someone to lift them up, that's massive. Thank you.
Thank you
really
much.
Hello.
Hello. So what's your favorite form of potato?
What? What do you mean? Not learning lessons. Like once we're reconcile, and I love all the stuff that we did with our mum, you know, Barbara Hershey, and remember, you know what, I think my favourite stuff with Lana is when we remember that we've known each other when we were little. I mean, when I actually read that script, I actually burst into tears. I thought that was so beautiful that we'd known each other when we were like 11 and 12. That was really cool.
Thank you.
Hi.
I have a question about something that's not on screen related. It's, what was it like working with Meryl Streep and holding up those belts for Meryl?
It's a tough call. We're so different. Working with Meryl Streep is brilliant. She is so chilled out and so just relaxed all the time, and her crosswords and her hugs, her slippers. And she was like, do you want a chai latte? Another chai latte. It was like hanging out with your mum, you know, tea and crosswords and slippers. I mean, I'm such a granny as a person. There was a lot of that and a lot of sitting around. And she was very, very, very kind and gracious to everybody. I'm a big proponent for always speaking to everybody, as everybody is equally as important as everybody else. And she's absolutely a class act in that regard. You know, she would speak to a PA the same as she would speak to an executive producer. And I think that speaks massively to someone's character.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Hello.
My name is Elizabeth, and today's my birthday.
Yay! Happy birthday!
And, I kind of want to test you. Do you think you can remember my name?
I'm not going to lie, I didn't hear it. But when you first said it, I didn't hear it. Someone else was talking. What was it? I didn't hear your name when you first said my name.
Hayden.
Hayden, thank you. Got it. Very well. Help me out.
Yes. My question is, because in a couple of weeks we won't be seeing you on our TV screens anymore on Friday night, do you think... What would you be doing on a Friday night, you know, because you probably watch yourself on Fridays,
I mean, I might tweet live, but I typically don't watch it live, because I'm usually somewhere else. I don't watch a lot of live TV, to be honest. I might watch it, like, the next day, have my coffee in bed or something with Mark. When it moved to Fridays, I wasn't really watching it. I watched it live more when it was on Sundays.
So what do you think you're doing on Friday night?
I'll still be at the club, girl. I'll be like in my pajamas watching Netflix with my
song.
Sorry, Hayden.
I was wondering.
are so close, was it hard playing with, like, hating her on the show?
No.
It would get up a wall and like, oh, we're so evil, and I'm like, why are we still fighting? You know what? We're still arguing the next season. I mean, we do prefer playing scenes, obviously, where we're getting along and being loving towards one another, but we both really enjoy going there and kind of getting feisty as well, so we're similar in that regard. So it did come easily, but, you know, if I had to choose, I would rather hug and kiss her than punch her in the face.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi. I was wondering what your biggest pet peeve is.
Texting and driving. I'm really over people just being on their phones all the time. I'm over it. I'm sick of looking at the top of somebody's head. I get very triggered by not getting someone's full attention, because I think if it's giving your attention to somebody else is the greatest gift you can give each other. Then if you're telling me a story, you need to be present for it, and this one, I'm like, oh my god, yeah, totally. Oh my, crazy. I can't bear it. We've all become, I mean, I'm guilty of it too. We're just sort of so disconnected from the present moment. So if I'm out with a friend and if they're sort of half checking their phone, half listening to my amazing story, I would rather reschedule when that person has the time to be fully present with me. Or I'd rather just be alone and go on Instagram by myself. But like being half with somebody is a massive pet peeve of mine.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. I want to know, how long does it take to get your makeup done?
It takes an hour and a half for the remakeup. It takes a bit longer if they have to do my hands. I typically fight for gloves, especially if I want to go to the toilet. Because the nails ping off. It's really fun when you're by yourself in a toilet trying to pick them up off the floor. Yeah. For a moment, I thought, wait, God, if only they can see me now. Glamorous. Makeup takes about an hour and a half, the hair takes about 45 minutes, then it takes about 20 minutes to get dressed, then I have to go and put the hat on. So from arriving to being on set, it takes about 3 hours.
Thank you.
Thank you. I like them.
My question is that we both know you have many sassy lines in the show. So what's your most favorite line that you've said was sass?
It's 5 years of them. I should do a coffee table though with all my classics. Classic Zelina lines. That'd be a good book for, like, your guest bathroom or something. I'll get on that. I'll do a rewatch and write them all down. My mum will help me, she's good with that stuff. So. I've not had the time where I say, I'm sorry if I'm good at what should I do? I liked it when I killed. I liked it when after I accidentally on purpose killed vampire. I just had my mum said to me, you didn't tell him a price! And I just responded, oops. Sideways. It was about 6 o'clock in the morning. We're like, we're never going to get this shot. This is ludicrous. And the director was adamant that we were going to keep going and keep going. And Ginny had all the dialogue, and she was trying to speak, shooting into her mouth, out of her nose. And we're all just stood around looking at each other. Thank you. and lines. That is brilliant. And the bed's not good. I'm like, so he's like, look away, I'm like, trying to look the other way. I'm just like, aww. Trying to make it or make it. I mean, it's very much like church eagles, you know, when you're just laughing at people's brains not working.
Thank you. Yeah.
Hi, Robin here. Of all the moments on the set, what was your greatest moment on the set?
I would say maybe shooting the musical was really fun for all of us. Because I felt like I was like an MTV superstar, and we all had our big songs, and it took a whole day to shoot Wicked Always Wins. And even just the crew was so excited to be doing it, that the energy on set, and everyone was like, woo! Like, we were just all giddy, and everybody was just, it was like we weren't even working, we were just playing and having fun, and it was such a magical.
You're gonna see that again, that was awesome.
Thank you.
Hi, Max. My question for you is, have you ever lost your voice singing Wicked Always Wins?
Singing it, no. Have I lost my voice? Yes. I did lose my voice, I got walking pneumonia a few years ago, and I almost completely lost my voice. The doctor said the only way to get it back is to go on complete voice rest for a week. But like me, not at all. That's just not possible. It's like, well, unless you want to damage your voice forever, I'm like, So I did, so I made like cue cards, so I go to Whole Foods, and I'm like, how do you want to pay? And I'm like, have things, like, I'm on voice rest, I cannot talk.
Yeah.
So I just had a notepad and paper and just wrote to everybody for a week, but it totally worked. Like a week later, my voice is back to normal.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Rebecca.
Beautiful.
Since Selena seems to be such a big Captain Swan fan, I was wondering what your favorite ship was.
How about I had a favorite ship? I think I just shipped Bex Arna, really. Romantical. Like, why do all ships have to be romantical? Why can't you just ship? I mean, because it was the only sibling relationship really on the show. So it was nice to kind of be part of something that was more family as opposed to everything having to be romantic. Hashtag sisters, hashtag for someone.
Sorry, I'm like really shook because I've known so much. But what is your advice to people with mental disorders?
Get professional help. I mean, you cannot struggle on your own, and make the list of everybody that loves you, will be there for you unconditionally, that you are having anxiety at 4 o'clock in the morning, who would actually take the call and who would stay on the phone with you until you felt better, and find out who your core peeps are, and whenever you've got time to be around other people, only hang out with people that are your people. Don't waste your time with everybody else, and just take a good care of yourself.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you. very much. And the last door here is brilliant. I'm actually going to have done that twice.
The door.
I love Chicago. I like the people, I like the pizza, the food. Oh, I went to, what's it called last night? Something in Ash. The food, the drink,
the people.
All of it, I suppose.
Thank you.
I love you.
Thank you.
Glad to be here. Thank you very much.
Hello.
Hi.
Sorry.
Sorry,
you said this is a safe space. So, what's your least favorite scene on the show?
Least favorite scene?
Yeah.
Anything I'm not in? I know what my least favorite scene to shoot was that I was in. Was that scene, that showdown that we did at the end of season 3 where Lana rips off and they rip off my thing and they drag me across the mud. It was when I got that whole big circle with like the heart and the this and the that. It was brutal shooting that. We had to work 2 days in the mud that smelled like poo. It was brutal. We were like in our heels just sinking into the powder. This is fun. We're earning our money, isn't it? It's really stinky. But then you watch it and you're like, oh, it's better with it adding the music and the flying monkeys. It's only worked. But to do it, not so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good luck, you're beautiful.
Dream of the past begins. All evil may be past.
recycled paper, so then it's a green book by
I like it, you're right.
So that being said, I really like Selena's character because she wears her heart on her sleeve. When she's happy, you know it. When she's sad, you know it. When she's angry, you know it. So my question is, in what ways do you like Selena, and in what ways are you different?
That's a good point. I think I am a lot like her in real life in terms of I do wear my emotions on my sleeve. Like, I'm a good actress in terms of I can pretend to be something else, but when I'm in my real relationships with my friends and my family, I'm completely always the way that I really feel. I don't really mind it. I'm totally what you see is what you get, you know, and I've got a ridiculous face, and I pull ridiculous faces, and then it's obvious how I'm really thinking. In fact, my husband says something and I'm like, it's like, what's on the face? I'm like, what goes? It's always obvious what I'm really feeling, so I think I'm very similar to Selena like that. And the ways that I'm different, I would say I'm probably a lot better at maybe taking a minute before I completely fly off that handle. So I learned that as I get older. But maybe let's just put a pin in my emotions for a minute and think about how I want to react rather than like, I'm going to kill you!
Thank you.
Good luck for that. Thank you very much.
Hello again.
Hello.
What would
What would be the creepiest thing you could say to a stranger while passing the street?
Creepiest thing I could say to a stranger?
Oh, very weird.
Maybe like saying a date as you walk by, like 23rd of December, like, what would ever happen?
Thank you.
Thank you. Hi.
Hello.
My question is, since you don't have children, how was it difficult to play the mother like a grown-up woman, essentially? How did you play it?
Oh, not really. I mean, it's just playing opposite someone that you love, and I've always had children in my life. I've had nieces and nephews for most of my life, so it came very naturally to me to play opposite someone that I just love dearly. You know, I've always been a bit of a mum to the people in my life. I'm a very maternal person, even to people that are older than me. So I'm a very protective, loving person, so it comes very easy to me to play one.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Hello. Hello. I was wondering, what's your favorite shower song?
My favorite shower song? My typical shower moments typically go to the Queen Bey, Beyonce. Like, I mean, to Beyonce in the shower. I used to have a radio shower, and then I moved and I can't find it. So you've just inspired me to bring music back into my shower. I'm going to get it from my mom. It's a really good idea. I love singing in the shower.
Hello.
Hi. What's your favorite part in the show?
Favorite part? What do you mean? Favorite?
Like, what do you like doing?
I like flying. I don't fly enough. Now that's because it's really expensive. I love how I'm flying this year. I should fly off like the gross $1,000 in my new normal car. Poofing out is about $5,000. Remember once when I was having a conversation, I shouldn't even still be in the sea. It makes no sense, I'm still here. Can't I just poof out? And they're like, well, we don't know, maybe we shouldn't. And I'm like, oh, hang on a minute. How much does a poof out cost? And I think it costs about $5,000. And I'm like, oh, I'll just walk out. Oh, I can give you $5,000? No, okay, I'll just walk out.
Thank you.
Flying on my broomstick is my favorite. Thank you, darling.
Hi. If there could be a third sister, who do you think it would be?
You. Ooh, a third sister. Hello. Anyone think of anyone?
Wait,
Cruella.
Cruella.
I was thinking
someone already on the show, you mean?
Well, yeah, I was thinking maybe Gothel. Maybe that's why she's come out.
I love Emma. Yeah, let's go with her. She's really fun. She finds me hilarious. I'm a big fan of her.